Welcome to Politics Done Right on KPFT. I am your host, Egberto Williams. This is the progressive program that will take the mystery out of politics. This is the program that will encourage you to make sure government becomes we the people. Whether you are liberal, conservative, or otherwise, you get to air your point of view. Give me a call at 713-526-5738. That is 713-526-KPFT. Remember, you can also send me a tweet to EGBERTOWILLIES. That is at Egberto Williams. Let us engage. It is politics done right.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Well, folks, welcome to one more edition of Politics Done Right. I'm Egberto Willis, your host. Folks, thank you for giving me this 1 hour. Hey, Shannon, how are you doing?
I am great, 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 Egberto. And, you know, this is our last day for Politics Done Right for our winter fun drive. And so we need you to turn out. If you usually call in every week and want to engage in, interesting topics that Egberto, he picks a blog entry every single week. And you know how much you love participating. So
yes. If
you usually call in and talk to me and tell me what you want to talk about, please call our wonderful volunteers out in Pledge Central. And that's 713-526-5738 or pledge online at kpft.org. But whichever way, we will be so, so grateful and we'll thank you in person.
Absolutely.
By
now,
name.
Shannon, how was your week?
It's been good. It's been good. It's been an action-packed week. It's been so wonderful to see all this life in the station.
I see Dwayne is right next to you. Dwayne, don't look so concerned. We're going to do it. All our Houston listeners out there, we want to hear from you. You know you want Politics Done Right on air. But guess what? We have a great show for you today. You know we're in pledge drive. Don't turn to another station because we're not just going to be pitching you, my friends. We're going to be talking, and I have a great guest out here. A guest who's going to enlighten you, a guest who's going to keep your blood flowing, and a guest who's going to empower you. So therefore, stick around for the entire show, and at the same time, give us a call at 713-JAM-KPFT, 713-526-5738. Look, folks, my guest today is David Cobb, National Outreach Director and spokesperson for Move to Amend. David is co-founder of Move to Amend, a former presidential candidate on the Green Party ticket, a former candidate for Texas Attorney General, one of the hardest, and I mean this to the core, I mean this to the heart, one of the hardest working activists that spends most of his time on the road empowering not only the poor, because it's not only the poor that needs empowering, especially now with the plutocracy that's taken over. It's us middle class folks. It's even some of the folks that think they're rich that needs empowering. And when you go to one of his events, I tell you, folks, the poor, the middle class, and the rich feel empowered. Before I continue with this, let me first say, today, David will discuss his upcoming community forum being held tomorrow, named Creating Democracy and Challenging Corporate Rule. It will be held at West Gray Cafe. Again, that will be at West Gray Cafe, located at 415 West Gray West Gray Street in Houston, Texas, between 7 p.m. on Friday, February 12th. That's tomorrow. That's mañana, amigos. So check it out. Before I go any further, David, how are you doing today?
Man, I'm doing great, Egberto. It's great to be with you, and it's also great to be back in the studios at KPFT. I haven't been, I used to spend a lot of time here a decade ago, right?
Yes.
So it's a real treat for me to be back in this studio.
And it's great to have you here, my brother. It's really great to have you here.
Thank you so much. You know, look, I know that we've got a lot to talk about. I'm going to actually make an appeal right now to say the conversation that we're about to have, the same conversation that Egberto has every week, is not heard on corporate media. Why? Because other media sources are dependent upon corporate dollars. They are controlled by the corporate media. This is the only place where you'll hear conversations about the issues that affect our lives without the corporate filter. News, information, analysis, a place where ordinary people have these conversations. So I'm going to join Egberto, I'm going to join Dwayne, I'm going to join Shannon in making an appeal to you to pick up the phone, 713-526-5738. That's 713-526-KPFT, 713-JAM-KPFT. The point is this, folks. This is a community tool where we, the people, talk to ourselves. There are very few of these that are available. This is the only one the fourth largest city in the United States.
Yes.
This is critical. So if you support what you hear week in, week out on Politics Done Right, you need to pick up the phone and make a call. And here's the thing I'm going to say, Egberto, at the beginning of this hour, if we hit $500, I'm going to put $100 of my own money in it to make it six. But if we don't hit $500, I'm not paying.
Hey.
That's a dead on for real. So
folks,
count it up. If you hit $500, you got me for $100. But if not, I'm not paying.
Listen, David Cobb, Move to Amend. That's the investment that they believe in this type of radio, folks. But look, before we go into the program, and I know you guys know that there are several programs here that I like, and I want to tell you about these programs because these are programs that are going to enlighten you. Folks, don't forget about The Monitor with Mark Bebawi on Wednesdays.
Mondays.
At 7 p.m.
Yes.
And we have Think Wing Radio with Mike Honig on Mondays at
9 p.m.
And we have Partisan Gridlock with Jeff Berg on
Fridays at 3.
And we have Jazz Latino, Afro-Cuban Latin Jazz with my buddy Juan Flores on Mondays at
10 p.m.
And I added a new one to my repertoire, Conscious Mindset.
I thought you would, especially since Brother Evan was on here last
Absolutely.
week.
So with Brother Evans on Sundays between 9 and 10:30 p.m. So folks, look, check out all of our schedule at kpft.org, and you can also make a donation at kpft.org, where you will find programming from music to politics to medicine to the eclectic. KPFT is listener supported, as David alluded to, public community radio.
100%
listener. 100% listener supported. So, listen, folks, please remember that if you like what you hear, visit kpft.org. I'm not going to go over all the pieces that we talk about that we're going to be on Periscope and that you can actually send me a tweet because you know you can. But for now, you know what time it is, right? Do you know what time it is?
It's time for the weekly blog post.
Now, I am superbly happy that this is a blog post that I wrote this weekend, because with my brother Cobb in the studio with me, I know he's going to have a whole lot to say. The title, and especially because of the work we do, the work he does. The title, the title is It's time for grassroots movements to coalesce around the Bernie Sanders revolution. Then I subtitle, the masses' support for Bernie Sanders rests on his message, authenticity, and consistency for his entire political career. I want to know, is that really true? Who knows? You guys listen. Anyhow, Bernie Sanders won in a landslide, a resounding victory against Hillary Clinton in the New Hampshire primary. Look, he beat Hillary Clinton 60% to 38%. Based on the exit polls, this was more than a resounding Hillary Clinton defeat. This was a defeat of the establishment. This was a defeat of incrementalism and authenticity. If you remember last week, we spoke about incrementalism. Go back to that blog and see what we're talking about. After all, if one digs deep into the message of both candidates, they are both attempting to promote middle-class-centric policies that on the surface appeals to most. The New Hampshire grassroots and rank-and-file Democrats reviewed the Democratic Socialists and the Democratic Establishment candidates. They found Bernie Sanders' message consistency that spanned several decades believable and attainable. They listened to Hillary Clinton's incrementalism purported to attain the same goal, albeit implicit corporate dictates unacceptable. Of course it was. The classic example is Sanders' healthcare proposal. Bernie Sanders wants to get corporations out of paying a medical bill, given that they deny coverage to many in order to make a profit for a few, also known as single-payer Medicare for all. Hillary Clinton continues to support that arcane construct that is nothing more than a transfer of middle-class wealth to the executives and shareholders of insurance corporations. The exit polls were strikingly stunning. They indicated that the masses are finally getting it. Bernie Sanders won every demographic classification sans people over 64 and people making over $200,000. And even those were close. Bernie Sanders, more than any politician, has raised the issue of Wall Street corporate control of American politics. He has promised to fund his campaign via the grassroots. Thus far, he is fulfilling that promise. Hillary Clinton's financing is decidedly PAC-based, and I gave links to all the monies that they are receiving and from whom they're getting it. So take a look at the blog as well with that, my folks. Many viewed former President Clinton's attack on Bernie Sanders immediately before the New Hampshire primary, when it was evident that Hillary Clinton would take a shellacking, as a faux pas. It was not. As David Brock said to Politico magazine, it was a signal. Here's what he said. I think that is about time that voters got a glimpse of reality, which is what's happening. And President Clinton did that. It was a strong call to arms, particular to her supporters, and included myself in that, who have stayed too quiet in the face of those character attacks and those over and over. What she correctly called the artful smear, we need to call attention to. David Brock, the founder of the Correct the Record and Rapid Response and Opposition Research Group that coordinates with the Clinton campaign, told Politico on Monday morning. Listen, in other words, here's the deal. The Clinton super PACs, the corporatocracy, and Wall Streets are ready to pounce. Bernie Sanders will not be treated with kid gloves anymore. One can expect the kitchen sink to be thrown at him. Is America at a turning point? Should grassroots movements pushing for a constitutional amendment to rid our politics of Wall Street control and corporate control jump into the Bernie Sanders revolution? Here it goes. Hillary Clinton has received almost unanimous support and endorsements from the Democratic establishment. Bernie Sanders is a lone ranger attempting to remake the Democratic Party into one that is middle-class centric and humane. There is much intersectionality between grassroots movements, groups like Move to Amend, and others. Bernie Sanders said the following in his New Hampshire speech. Tonight, we serve notice to the political and economic establishment of this country that the American people will not continue to accept a corrupt campaign finance system that is undermining American democracy, and we will not accept a rigged economy in which ordinary Americans work longer hours for lower wages while almost all new income and wealth goes to the top 1%. That is a large part of the core of many of these grassroots groups that are fighting for this in the aggregate. Sanders also pointed out that much of the tenets he stands for are transpartisan and trans-ideological. How does he say that? The people of New Hampshire have sent a profound message to the political establishment, to the economic establishment, and by the way, to the media establishment. What the people here have said is that given the enormous crisis facing our country, it is just too late for the same old establishment politics and establishment economics. The people want what? Change. What the American people are saying, and by the way, I hear this not just from progressives, but from conservatives and from moderates, is that we can no longer continue to have a campaign finance system in which Wall Street and the billionaire class are able to buy elections. Americans, no matter what their political view may be, understand that is not a democracy, or that is not what a democracy is about. That is what oligarchy is about, and we will not allow that to continue. I do not have a super PAC. And I do not want a super PAC, so says Sanders. Now look, Sanders even touched on a subject that many grassroots groups not associated specifically with racial injustice tend to minimize. By the way, Move to Amend makes this a central tenet of its organizing methodology. He said the following, and when we talk about transforming America, it means ending the disgrace of the country having more people in jail than any other country in the world, disproportionately African American and Latino. Not only are we going to fight to end institutional racism and a broken criminal justice system, we're going to provide jobs and education for our young people, not jails and incarcerations. We're coming to the end now. Sanders also unequivocally came out in support of protecting Mother Earth. He also took a decidedly non-neocon view of international policy. The excitement and interest in the Bernie Sanders campaign leads one to believe that given the proper impetus, his candidacy and ultimate presidency could make a change in the body politic. It could be the necessary catalyst to finally activate an apathetic sleeping giant, the American middle class. The massive amount of donation to his campaign from the grassroots is probative. This just may be that instant in time when grassroots movements need to coalesce with all its might in support of a candidate that just might start the reversal from our path to fascistic oligarchy to one of a real democracy based on the social needs of all Americans. Folks, give us a call, 713-526-5738. We utterly depend on you for the survival of a station that will give you the word. David.
Yes, Egberto.
Your thoughts?
Well, listen, you know, I'm a Green, and I was a Democrat and a Democratic Party organizer for years and years before Bill Clinton came along and turned me into a Green Party organizer. Why? NAFTA, Don't Ask, Don't Tell, the Telecommunications Act. I mean, I can go down the list of the corporate sellout. Because remember this, Bill Clinton was actually at the heart of what was known then as the Democratic Leadership Council, the DLC, right?
Exactly.
The DLC doesn't exist anymore.
Wait, David, I want you to say it the way you told me that in the
Green
Room.
I'm going to, Egberto, yes. Because the Democratic Leadership Council doesn't exist anymore. First of all, what was the Democratic Leadership Council? It was an effort to bring together Wall Street, corporate executives, the billionaire class, if you
right.
will, to find a way to make them comfortable in the Democratic Party. And the reality is the DLC doesn't exist anymore. You know why? Because it's now the DNC. The Democratic National Committee is literally owned by Wall Street and the big bankers. And we're seeing this by how the superdelegates are being allocated, by the decisions that Debbie Wasserman Schultz has made around the debates. I could go on and on, but here's the point, Egberto. What the Bernie Sanders campaign represents to me is an effort that I have not seen since Jesse Jackson in 1984 and 1988, an actual coalition. It looks like the Rainbow Coalition with
yes.
young people,
yes.
right?
Yes.
Quite honestly.
Yes.
I've never seen anything like it.
By the way, that's what the media is not alluding to. They constantly want to say that Bernie Sanders attracting all these white people. Bernie Sanders attracting everybody.
I don't know if you've noticed it, Egberto, but Killer Mike has lined up behind Bernie Sanders.
Yes.
Michelle Coates has lined up behind Bernie Sanders. Michelle Alexander
has lined up behind Bernie.
I mean, like, I I've never seen anything quite like this.
Right.
So I think from my perspective, I look at this as an assessment. Now, I'm a Green, not a Democrat. But like you, first and foremost, I'm a progressive. Right?
Absolutely.
And so I don't care whether here's what I know, Egberto. The entire history of the United States and systemic social change is actually quite easy to describe. It's hard to do, but a very easy formula. First, you need a movement that is broad, deep, conscious, politically educated, aware of what it's doing. Secondly, you need an electoral arm to represent that movement. If you have a movement but no electoral arm, then you can change people's minds, but you can't change policies. If you have a political party but no mass movement behind it, you merely have rhetoric. What we've seen throughout history, whether it is the abolition of slavery, women's suffrage, the ending of child labor, the direct election of the United States Senate, the pure food and drug laws, civil rights, all of them required those two factors, right? What I'm witnessing today is within the Democratic Party for the first time since the 1980s, an effort to coalesce around a candidate who is reflecting those sorts of values. I think it's quite interesting. Now, again, I'm a Green, so my job is this. If Bernie Sanders does not become the nominee, then there'll be a plan B for you in the general election. But right now, I will admit, I would have bet any amount of money that the Democratic National Committee would not allow Bernie to get this far. He's already proven me wrong. He basically fought to a dead even tie in Iowa.
Before you get on that point, let me tell you that he actually won Iowa. You're not going to hear that. What happens is we have videos now that actually show the machinations, that the tricks that actually were done with the delegate counts using, what's the name of the third candidate?
O'Malley.
They used O'Malley to actually change the delegate formulas and that sort of thing.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I mean, I believe that that is actually true, but at the end of the day, and then let's look at New Hampshire, right?
Right.
Bernie Sanders gets over 60% of the vote. Do you know that there has not been that big a defeat in a primary?
Ever.
In modern history, that has not happened, and they're glossing over it.
David, let's go to our program director. He's one of the best pitchmans out here. Ernesto?
Well, he is going to be there at 30. But he's we're waiting for our first phone calls to come in. I think Augie might have taken a few already. But what's really cool about what y'all are talking about how Bernie's against the super PACs, more, you know, he talks about how people are bought and sold by the corporations donating tons of money into campaigns and how they're really pulling the strings. Well, just like for a membership here, it's $25, just basic membership. If you want to back something you believe in, and look how successful Bernie has been with that same format, $25 donations from just normal everyday people.
Absolutely.
If you believe in something, just put just $25 down, and if we get enough people standing up for what they believe in, we can keep this place afloat.
Absolutely. Now, before we go, I want to remind folks that we also have some real goodies that we have here, okay? Here are the goodies, my folks. We have a t-shirt. I'm coming to you right now, Ernesto. We have the Politics Done Right t-shirt. And how much, what kind of a pledge do we have for that? Do you have it with you? I think it's a $90 pledge for our Politics Done Right t-shirt alone. We also have my book, As I See It, Class Warfare. Please check that out. I think that donation is, I don't remember what, but Shannon is busy looking it up. But I do know that we have the combination of the Politics Done Right t-shirt and the book, As I See It, Class Warfare, the Only Resort to Right-Wing Doom, for $150. Take it away, Ernesto.
Absolutely. 713-526-5738. As Shannon said, we are awaiting our very first call for the program. We're asking you to make your pledge of support for important contextual media, media that makes an enormous difference in your understanding of the world around us. 713-526-5738. 713-526-5738. Whether you're intrigued by the Bernie Sanders campaign or are skeptical of it, get a chance to really understand a deeper look at the 2016
I'll send you messages on the computer.
Not only the candidates who are running, but the issues and the opposite side of those particular candidates and some of the national issues which are impacting
all of us. Yeah, I was like, no.
So we're asking you to make your pledge of support this hour. We're asking you to ensure the KPFT can continue to bring you the unique programming that you get here on Pacifica Radio. 713-526-5738.
Absolutely, folks. Look, this is the last day of Politics Done Right doing a fun drive. We go back where when you make your calls, you talk directly to me, you talk directly to Shannon. So please give
Certainly
us a call.
Do. And I'm so happy to take your calls. If you agree with us, great. If you don't, we're so happy to have that engaging conversation come through. And, you know, we take every person's call because freedom of speech is very important for democracy to flourish.
But we need your calls right now. Get the t-shirt, get the book.
That's at the $90 level for the t-shirt. For the combo, I believe it's $120. Let me take
No, I think it's $150 for the combo.
Oh, yes, you're right. $150 for the combo. And tell us a little bit about more about your book.
Look, the As I See It, Class Warfare, the Only Resort to Right-Wing Doom. I wrote that thing in Starbucks. corporate coffee. But I spent the time, and it was out of frustration because of what was going on in our body politic. It's something that everybody, I think, should do.
You'll need to start visiting the corner coffee shops that we have right here locally, just so we back local.
Right. But one of the things I tell you in that book is you are the solution, and you don't have to sit down and wait to not do anything. You can actually get out there and do it all. You can be a part of the solution. You can be a part of learning what's going on in our body politic, and not only learning what's, but find people to associate with and actually make a change, make a positive change. So, folks, we do need you to call 713-526-5738. According to Ernesto, we don't have any pledges yet. We really do need. Last week, we made what we needed to make. We need to make it again today, and we also have to recover from 2 weeks ago. So please call 713-526-5738.
Yeah, be a part. Were coming in like crazy last week, and it was so wonderful to hear from all of you. If we felt very, we can hold our heads high when we walked out of the station. We knew that you believed in having this kind of platform.
Absolutely. David, talk to me. What do you think about tell these users why it is, because you're all over this country. You spend your time all through the country. You spend all your time listening to all kinds of media. Why is it so important that we have grassroots, the people that are listening to this show right now, why is it important that they are the ones supporting this station?
So the fact that you're listening to this program at all says that you're already more conscious and aware than most Americans. Why? Because KPFT is a source of non-corporately filtered news, information, and analysis. But you probably already know that because you're listening. So I'm actually going to give you a specific example of actually how that works. First, actually, I'll give you two. One, in 2004, when I was the Green Party candidate for president of the United States, George Bush steals another election. John Kerry doesn't concede. He capitulates. The corporate media goes along with it. Everybody knew that he had actually stolen another election. So we were able, and the Green Party went on to Democracy Now!, rang the bell, began to say, if we could just raise enough money to be able, we will file a recount, even though John Kerry will not do so. Egberto, we raised hundreds of thousands of dollars within just a couple of days because of community radio.
Absolutely.
It was community radio and the internet were the only ways we were able to do that. Now, and here's the other thing. You know what happened? We did not actually get a full recount, but what we did do was get an opportunity to investigate what happened in Ohio. Do you know that there are three convictions in Cuyahoga County about from election administrators who were charged with fraud? And I'll go you even better, Egberto. Do you know we were able to basically launch a citizens' movement against the use of black box voting or electronic DRA machines? They were all the rage. It looked like the entire country were going to be able to use it. But because we were able to file that recount, shine a light for a brief moment on how our votes are being counted or not counted, we were able to actually build a movement to stop it. Now, I'm going to take you up fast forward to 2010 when the Supreme Court issues its horrific Citizens United versus Federal Election Commission case. At that time, Move to Mend was 12 people in a living room. 12 people thinking, we need to do something about this. We need to actually build a mass movement to demand the abolition of the concept of corporate constitutional rights and money as First Amendment protected political speech. Egberto, 12 people in a living room. We launched ourselves on the internet and community radio. Community radio stations were the only media outside the internet that was actually talking about what we were talking about. Egberto, 12 people in a living room, we're 400,000 people today.
There you go.
We've had 16 states pass resolutions of support. 600 communities at the city council or county commissioners have voted to endorse us. And we've been on the ballot over 300 times, won every single one of them. Egberto, that includes liberal places like San Francisco and Boston, but we've also won it in conservative places like Montana,
Utah. Right.
I mean, I could go down the list of places that we've won. We've won everywhere we've been. And the reality is this, if it had not been for the existence of a network of community radio stations across this country, we would not have been able to get the word out.
Folks, we need to hear from you, please. 713-526-5738. We are almost half done with the show. We really need to hear your rings. Now, I don't hear any rings coming in yet. 713-526-5738. Remember, we have those wonderful gifts. Ernesto, do you have some gifts other than the Politics Done Right t-shirt and the class warfare book?
We do, as a matter of fact. If you heard about a gift on a previous program, call our wonderful volunteers at the Pledge Center. We are happy to track down a gift. Perhaps you heard about one of the books or DVDs on Democracy Now! Earlier today or during this fundraising campaign. Perhaps you heard about tickets to lots of the fantastic performances coming through town. Just give our volunteers here a ring. We will be more than happy to find whatever it is you may be curious about. The gifts are just an incentive. They're our effort to say, hey, we appreciate that you're willing to make that pledge, and we're going to give you something extra because we do really value what you give to KPFT. So your pledge is tax deductible.
Thank you for that call.
713-526-5738, and we're more than happy to get you linked up with whatever gift you may be curious about. We just need you to make that pledge of support this hour.
Look, folks, as you know as well, we have matching. For every new member that we get right now, we get another $10 from
Max,
a wonderful donor.
And he would like to challenge 9 other of our longstanding, members of our family who want to see us grow and flourish in our community and want to just encourage those that have been listening for a long time or those that are new to, picking us up on the dial, that you come out and stand up for us and stand with us so that we have something amazing to be able to have that exposure of the truth, because transparency in our political process is critical for democracy to thrive.
Absolutely.
And whenever there is that kind of corruption, you need this kind of independent format to be able to hear the truth.
Now, when did you last see David Cobb on MSNBC? When did you last see David Cobb on ABC? You're laughing, but I'm serious here about this particular issue. The Move to Amends movement has accomplished so much, and absent a community radio informing of what has been done for the constitutional amendment, absent the internet,
we wouldn't exist.
You wouldn't exist.
We wouldn't exist. I mean, there's no doubt about it, Egberto. Again, that's the reason that I'm actually making an appeal directly to folks who may have remembered the Ohio recount back in 2004, who might be a Move to Amend supporter. Frankly, if you're a follower of politics, whether it was Jesse Jackson or Dennis Kucinich or Bernie Sanders, I mean, progressive politics have always depended upon community radio, because community radio is the only place our voices can be heard.
Absolutely.
And that's the reason it's so important for you to actually call 713-526-5738. That's 713-526-5738. The reality is we need you. But here's something else. You need us. You need a place where you're actually going to hear the truth. And whether you agree or disagree with the opinions that you hear, there is no other place on the radio dial where you will hear unadulterated opinions being shared by people. We encourage this.
Well said, David. Well said. You know, to keep this progressive point of view alive, it is critical to keep KPFT strong. Our independent programs are funded and supported only by you, the listener, and we're able to exert the kind of independence for one simple reason.
Thank you for that call.
Because we answer to only you, our listener. And if you value that, please call 713-526-5738 to pledge your support.
Shannon, that is so true. But folks, we're down to only 28 minutes, and we really need the calls to start stepping up. So I ask you that you give us a call at 713-526-5738. This is the only station. And, you know, there's something else that Shannon didn't say this time around, or David didn't say.
What is that?
And here it goes. David made mention, and he said, look, even if you don't agree with the opinion, you know that you're getting unadulterated information.
Exactly.
But here's the deal. If you don't like an opinion, you can actually reach us.
Yes.
Have you ever tried to reach Broca's successor? You can't reach any of those guys in their ivory towers. You can come into this station,
yes,
which people have done.
I get people that call all the time that do not agree with the statement that was broadcast. And I say, well, thank you for calling and wanting to participate. Please hold, and we're happy to have you engage in our conversation.
Absolutely. It's the thing about it is when you pledge to KPFT, you become, and we really mean this, you become a part of the family. You become a voting member here on the team. So you actually you are a part of the group that runs this station.
Yes.
You are a part of the group that runs this station. Absent KPFT, and we are the last one here in Southeast Texas, the last independent station in Southeast Texas. And we have to come to you every so often with this, not because we want to, not because we like to. I much prefer speaking to you individually on the phone, discussing the politics with us both learning. That is the goal of Politics Done Right. All of you guys listening out there that listen to me all week, all of you that send me all those emails, all of you that send me all those Facebook posts, we know what you're looking for, and we know it's Politics Done Right. We know it's a lot of the other programs on KPFT. So please give us a call at 713-526-5738 and make that pledge. We try our best to make it that we're going nowhere. We try to keep this. David, look at the chairs. Do they look?
They're the same chairs I sat in a decade ago.
There you go. We are frugal with your money. Anyhow, let's see if Ernesto has anything to tell us back there.
We have some pledges that are wrapping up on the phone, which is a great thing to hear, but we do need to get every single phone line going at this moment. We would love to hear from you. Your call is going to be music to our ears here at the Pledge Center. If you can make your call right now, 713-526-5738 is that number to call. Let's say we have two calls that are processing right now, which is wonderful to see. We have a very, very big goal. We need to reach on this final edition of Politics Done Right, and we would love to get you on the lines of police. Help out KPFT this hour, 713-526-KPFT.
Did you hear what our program director said, Ernesto? He said, on this final Politics Done Right, if you don't want it to be final Politics Done Right, you may want to give us a call, 713-526-57. I'm playing with you guys, but here's the deal. Look, we really need to hear from you. 713-526-5738. Please give us a call. You know we're really here for you. We're here to provide you with all. It's not just information that we're giving you. We're also giving you, we are giving you engagement. When we have folks like David on board, we're empowering you. Because, David, before Ernesto reads that, tell them about what you're going to do tomorrow. And here's the reason why. Because that is going to be empowering.
Well, I hope so, Egberto. You know, as you know, I'll be actually presenting both part lecture, part impassioned plea, part history lesson on how it is that corporations have come not just to exercise power in this country, but how they have actually ruling us, how they've hijacked all of the institutions. But I don't spend that much time doing it. What I actually spend most of my time is challenging people how they can get involved to actually build a movement that is capable of abolishing in its entirety the idea that corporations have constitutional rights and to get money out of elections. And the thing, Egberto, that's so exciting to me is this works whether I'm at an Occupy group or a Tea Party group, whether I'm talking to Democrats, Republicans, Greens, Libertarians, Independents. Everybody knows that we have a system in this place where a small ruling elite are literally controlling the country. Frankly, that's the reason I think that what you're seeing is anti-establishment candidates in both the Democratic and the Republican Party actually not just doing well, but upsetting the apple cart. Nobody would have predicted this 6 months ago. Certainly I wouldn't have. No, I was actually predicting the opposite. I was like, yeah, Bernie's great, but there's nowhere he's going to go.
Right.
You know, so here's my point. Tomorrow night, 7 p.m. at the West Gray Diner, I will be giving a presentation and an invitation to participants to come and learn about Move to Mend, learn how we've gone from 12 people to 400,000 people, help you form a Move to Mend chapter in Houston, Texas, help you pass resolutions, help you with the training necessary for letters to the editor, how to use talk radio, both on the right as well as KPFT. The point is we make tools available and we provide training on those tools. You know, Egberto, the invitation that I'm going to make now is whether you agree or disagree with anything that you've heard me say so far, two things. One, give us a call now and let's have a conversation on air. Two, come in person to the West Gray Diner tomorrow at 7 p.m. and let's have a conversation. Because what I've learned is we can have disagreements on policy proposals, right? Progressives and conservatives have different ideas about what sort of policies the government should do. But I've almost never met somebody who agreed that artificial entities known as corporations should be treated as if they are persons with constitutional
Absolutely.
Rights. This is not an issue. This is a principle of self-government. At the end of the day, the question is, are we the people going to govern ourselves through a democratic process and make sure that individual human rights are protected? Or are we going to allow a billionaire class to rule over all of us and allow these things known as corporations to overturn the laws?
Absolutely, folks. And this is not pie in the sky. What David is talking about is definitely not pie in the sky. And when I speak about David being an empowering spokesperson for the movement, I'm talking about a real movement, not something that we just think may happen, but we've all seen this in action. And what stations like KPFT and other independent stations do is they empower us all to be able to bring that to you. Because I tell you what, it's not going to be coming to you from ABC, CBS, NBC, MSNBC, or any of these other stations. These are all corporate owned. We are independent, and the reason we have our independence is because of you. You are the ones that give us the independence, and that is the reason. It isn't about begging for money. It's about asking everyone to do their part. You know, we sit down and we complain about the corporatocracy, or we complain about how government is not working right, or we complain about all these issues. We can actually change that, but the only way we change that is being part of the solution. And we can't look. I had a phrase I always said, the plutocracy has Coke, meaning the Coke brothers. We have you. We much rather have you, have us all, than to have the oligarchy or the corporatocracy funding us, because the only way we make a change and take this country back, you know, when you hear folks talk about taking the country back, it's real. It is actually real. And the only way we take this country back is if we have a real participatory democracy, and we can only have that if people participate. That's what it means. And participation also means investing in what's going to set us free.
And what's more, you know, what's more community than grassroots movements?
Absolutely.
And empowering. I mean, when you really look at the power of the people, how was it taken away?
We allowed it to happen. We became apathetic. We decided we would pay $150 a month to use cable.
Yes.
We will pay $500 for a pair of shoes that go to that whose profits, billions of profits, go to a few people, but we won't invest in ourselves.
Yes, and we allow that our time to be bought.
Absolutely. So what I'm asking you folks to hear my words, because I like to qualify something. None of these donations come to any of us here. David does what he does out of dedication to the cause. I do what I do out of dedication of the cause. Shannon as well. We are all volunteers working hard because we know we need to have a change. So please call 713-526-5738. We really need you.
And yes. And the skeleton crew we really do have is just a small body of about 10 employees, about a number of full-time and just a handful of part-time. And, you know, you're paid just
subsistence.
It's a small amount, but really what we're here for is we all have a passion for a place like this. We know this is a rare gem. You won't find it anywhere else. Pacifica, we're one of five Pacifica stations in the United States, and
right.
We're the only one representing here in the South, in the middle of the United States.
Absolutely. Let's go back to Ernesto, and then we'll go back to talking a little bit of policy again, and then we'll come back to you folks. But please call now, 713-526-5738. Ernesto.
Hey, we do have two folks from Houston, Suhong and Bernie, who are calling in, but we have folks out in Tomball, Spring, Kingwood, Sugarland, Missouri City, wherever you may be. We would love to hear from folks out in Clear Lake and anywhere else in between. Make your call right now in these closing time we have with you, about a little less than 20 minutes to go, which means every single call is going to be a big help right now. Still a long way to go to our goal, about $200 in toward that goal. I think we can get there, but we won't be able to do it without you. So please, during this last edition of Politics Done Right for this membership campaign, we're asking for you to please call 713-526-5738.
It was about this time, Ernesto, that the call started to flow in like crazy last week. So I'm going to ask for a repeat performance. 713-526-5738. Get the Politics Done Right t-shirt designed by KPFT's own Patrick. Nice t-shirt. 713-526-5738.
That demonstrates the power of the ballot and the vote.
Yes, it actually shows you the power of the ballot. So give us a call and get that. It's only a $90 donation. And guess what, folks? When you get that t-shirt, remember this. When we say $90 for the t-shirt, it's mostly a donation. But here's the deal. You don't have to pay $90. You can actually do it like a cup of coffee a month, because they'll take your pledge and they'll bill your credit card monthly. So you're not going to be out much. Get the combination of the t-shirt, the Politics Done Right t-shirt, and the book, As I See It, Class Warfare, The Only Resort to Right-Wing Doom. A combined $150. But again, that's not what you're going to be paying if you go ahead and do it on a monthly basis.
You're paying to keep KPFT alive.
Absolutely.
You know, it costs a lot to keep all of these factors, the transmitter up running, electricity, our phone bills here, because we call and we report on international issues.
Absolutely.
So it takes money. Unfortunately, you know, everything's not passion driven. We are.
Yes, we are, but it's still quiet. It's still quiet.
We need you.
We need a call. 713-526-5738. I can see your, or I can feel that you have your fingers on that phone, folks. I know you have the fingers on that phone. Give me that call. 713-526-5738. David, you know, that is one of the biggest problems that we have, generally speaking, in getting, and it's not only progressive movements. I think it's all grassroots movements. Funding is generally the issue, mostly because we know folks. First of all, folks are strapped for money. A lot of times, we understand that. However,
thank you for that call.
But there's something else that we understand. Everybody sits down and think the other person is likely going
sure.
to do it.
You know, in fact, Kitty Genovese, there's a famous sociology story that they tell about Kitty Genovese, the woman who was actually murdered in New York City. It went on for hours, sadly.
Right.
She was attacked. She was screaming. And all of the people who heard it when they were interviewed later all said, I thought somebody else would call.
Exactly.
And it's not that they are evil people.
No,
it's
they're
that
not.
They thought somebody else would call. But folks, let me tell you something. You are that somebody else. And here's the thing. We've just hit 3:45. That means we've got 15 minutes. So if you, like me, are a procrastinator, friends, now is your time to shine. It really is time to do like the last caller did, pick up the phone and make your donation or call and have a conversation
right.
with us on air. But here's the thing. We need you. You need us. Because what we know is this. Every movement needs a media. Every movement needs a place to talk to itself, to challenge the narrative that we are constantly told. Because let me tell you something. There is no such thing as the liberal media. But here's something else. There's no such thing as the conservative media.
Exactly.
It's the corporate media.
It's the corporate media.
The corporate media, which is all about... if there was such a thing as a liberal media, we would hear people constantly talking about, you know, the right to health care is a fundamental human right.
Absolutely.
Or the need to deconstruct the prison industrial complex, or the need for a sane immigration policy. I could go down the list
right.
of the things that we would hear on liberal media. If there was a conservative media, actually what you would be constantly hearing would be about the principles and values and the virtues of the founding fathers and so
right.
forth. Instead, actually what you hear on corporate media is a constant barrage of buy. Buy,
exactly.
buy. In fact, do you know that the entire business model of corporate media is not the content itself? That's just to get you hooked so that they can sell your eyeballs, your ears, your imagination
exactly.
space to the advertiser. The product being sold is you, the consumer. We don't do that at KPFT. This station doesn't do that. This station actually has a completely different model, which is we want to provide a platform for the people to talk to themselves.
Exactly.
Which is why on Politics Done Right, there is an actual invitation every week. Call whether you agree or disagree. Let's have a conversation.
Absolutely.
Very few places does that happen anymore. It used to happen all over the place. Here's the thing, folks. You've got a short window of time to make your donation to KPFT so that it registers for Politics Done Right. If you're listening now at this moment, it's probably because you have become a fan of Egberto Huiles and what he does on this station. Every week as an unpaid volunteer. Well, we need you to register your support now. Those of you who call in all the time, those of you who send emails, those of you who do Facebook posts, those of you who are participating, now is the time to call in.
Absolutely. Look, and the station appreciates it. I appreciate it more so than you know. So again, please give us a call at 713-526-5738. Do remember, we have the nice Politics Done Right t-shirt made by Senor Patrick, and we also have the book, As I See It, Class Warfare, The Only Resort to Right-Wing Doom. Combination, $150.
And we're happy to split it up into small payments, anything from $10 a month to even smaller. It could be a coffee a month.
Absolutely.
But, you know, you don't remember that coffee you had about a few weeks ago. It's not still satisfying you, but we are the gift that keeps on giving.
And you'll see that t-shirt, and you can read that book, and
it's tax deductible.
And you know what? You know, as far as folks sometimes who like to talk to the host or whatever, you can always reach us. That's the thing about us. You can't reach all these other guys. You can reach us because we are one of you. We are part of the family. We are part of the community. You are part of the family.
You are
part of the community.
And we need to know that you actually enjoy the show. You actually let our programs director know that you want to keep this on the dial, that this is an important show to
Absolutely.
You.
Absolutely. 713-526-5738.
You know, Egberto, so many times I hear people talk about the apathy of the American people. And mm-hmm. I realize, actually, Americans and people in general are not apathetic mm-hmm. because apathy means you don't care.
Right.
go into any pool hall, bowling alley, and ask somebody's opinion. They will give you their opinion. So there, we know that people care. But you know what's really sad? People are cynical. They don't think there's anything that they can do.
Right.
That there's nothing that they can do. So here's my challenge. If you want to fight corporate power, go to movetomen.org and sign up. Join 400,000 people growing across this country who are actually doing something. And if you appreciate having a place where ordinary people can talk to themselves over the airwaves, then call us at 713-526-5738. That's 713-526-KPFT. And actually register your support for this. Please don't be apathetic. Please don't be cynical, because actually there is something that you can do. You know, $40 a day is a $40 membership is literally 11 cents a day.
Yes.
11 cents is what we're asking of you. And remember, at the very beginning of this program, we got 10 minutes left. I'm going to remind you, if we hit $500, I'll throw in $100 as a guest.
You hear that, folks?
How many places do you think guests actually are willing to make a donation?
Very few times. So look, folks,
I'm very serious. If you don't hit $500, I'm not going to throw in my
folks, hundred. Give me a call, 713-526-5738. Don't give up on that $100 from David Cobb. Let's get 713-526-5738. Is Ernesto out there?
I am, as a matter of fact. And I want to send a big thank you out to Anonymous out in Magnolia, helping us out. Also got to send a big thank you out to Eden out in Houston,
new member
who appreciates the passion and the perspective of the show and wanted to call in a very generous contribution. 713-526-5738. Bob is at the end of the table wrapping up another pledge. We have somebody to thank in just a bit, but we'd love to thank you. Coming up next, please make your call right now. 713-526-KPFT.
Folks, Ernesto, we got 9 minutes left. I'm just curious, how safe is my $100? Because I am dead serious. I told Egberto, if we hit 500, I'll throw in $100. But if this show doesn't hit the $500 mark, I'm going to walk out with that $100 in my pocket. So how close are we?
We are pretty close, actually.
Folks, we need another call. 713-526-5738. Come on, folks, give me that call. Look, David is my good friend.
It's true. You know, we're very good friends.
We go back a long time in the movement. And I want somebody to stick it to David. You know.
Listen, but between getting into my wallet or seeing Dwayne Bradley dangle over the edge of the Houston Metro Center, I mean, like, you know, that may be the sweetest premium I've ever heard.
Yes, I know.
The opportunity to have the general manager rappel down the side of a building.
Yes.
I mean, that's about as good as it gets.
Absolutely. Hey, Dwayne, listen, Dwayne.
Hey, what?
Let me tell you something. I think all of us are going to have to throw some money because we want to see that happen, buddy.
I want to see it happen. I'm excited to be part of it if it does happen, and we'll memorialize it in probably several ways. But you got to make the call right now at 713-526-5738, 526-KPFT. Yeah, it's Saturday, 3 o'clock, the Metro HQ building, 1900 Main Street. It's on the side. I just verified it's going to be on the facing of the Metro building at the Allen Parkway. So it's right there.
This is real, dude.
Drive by and watch. This is great. I'm going to stick around for it.
Folks, I need your calls, my dear friends, my
$50
family.
$50 or more. You just forego the gift. Don't make us buy you something and send it to you. Don't make us print you a T-shirt or go buy something from Amy Goodman and transship it to you. Go buy your own book. Go get your own T-shirt.
There you go.
Drop this just free and clear into KPFT. Take the tax deduction if that's something you can do. And then go ahead and know that you're sending me over the edge.
Yes, 713-526-573. Folks, we need to hear from you. Remember, Politics Done Right is the show that you want to hear now.
And you need to send this show over the edge. You got 6 minutes left to do it. 6 minutes left. We got to hit that 500. And when you hit 500, I'll throw in $100. That'll make it $600. But this is the thing. Ernesto has already told us we're very close. We got literally less than 6 minutes now for you to pick up the phone, call. Remember, we are so very close. You make that call. Your call could very well be the one that triggers the challenge that I've put forward. Whenever $500 comes in, I'll throw in $100 as a guest. I want to ask, I challenge you to think about how many times have you heard a guest on a radio show dig into their own pocket as a challenge. So I have a challenge to you. And here's another challenge. If you've given Bernie Sanders $27 as hundreds of thousands of dollars, then give KPFT $27. And here's another challenge. If you are one of the 400,000 supporters of Move to Mend, then give KPFT a donation, because the reality is we would not exist if it were not for KPFT and other community radio stations. If you are one of the people who knows that the billionaire class have stolen our country and know that corporate media is one of the ways they've done it, then pick up the phone now in the last 5 minutes and make a pledge to Politics Done Right, KPFT, 713-526-5738. We got less than 5 minutes. We need you as much as you need us.
Please give us a call now.
Well said, David. Well said. You know, and Pacifica's founders sought to create an independent, non-commercial radio in the service of peace, social, and racial justice. And that's a radio as a forum to ignite the democratic spirit. But, you know, it starts with your participation.
Call.
It starts with you deciding to pick up and SPAC what you believe in with a small donation, $25. As a member, you actually get some discounts at these local, the foodie card. That gives you discounts
to
in the community.
That, yes.
Of the there's Pat Greer's Kitchen, there's Aladdin's Cafe, there's Mystic Cafe, and there's a variety
Shannon,
of others.
Do we give them the card once they make a
yes.
pledge? They get a card.
As a member, you have your card.
As a member, you get a discount card, folks. What
and
could
so
be better than that?
And so you're backing what you believe in, just like just taking it away from having the corporations choose who wins and who stands behind. Stand up for yourself. Stand
Absolutely.
Up for what you believe in. And call 713-526-5738.
We got 3.5 minutes, and I am looking at a pledge card. I'm going to start putting in my charge card number, but I'm only going to sign it if we hit $500. Ernesto tells us we're close, but not quite there. Your phone call could be worth your pledge plus $100. 713-526-5738. And again, I'm not looking. Thank you
thank
so
you
much. I
call.
Hope that's the one that makes
be
me
the call that
actually
makes a difference.
That makes the difference. Because here's the thing. I am a guest. I actually came on here because I wanted to talk about Move to Mend and the growing campaign to abolish corporate constitutional rights. Instead, we spent most of the time appealing to you to keep this station on the air. Because without this station, the movement will die. I'm not being facetious. I'm not being melodramatic. The reality is we have to have a way where we, the people, can talk to each other. The corporations are cutting us off from one another. It's the reason that community radio and the internet are so incredibly important now. We know they're corporatizing the airwaves. They're corporatizing television. They're corporatizing radio. They are corporatizing the newspapers.
They're corporatizing everything.
Everything. KPFT is one of the very few places where we know that corporations are not allowed. We don't want your money. We don't want your advertising. We will not accept your advertising. This is listener supported, 100%. So this is critical. We know that you depend upon KPFT as a source of non-corporately filtered news, information, analysis, and some kick-ass music. We know that. So here's the thing. In the last 2 minutes, it's time for you to show your appreciation,
folks,
your love, support what you already need.
Hail, hail, David. Hail, hail, David Cobb. Anyway, folks, Ernesto, talk to me.
So we want to send some thank yous out, including out to Jared, first time pledging for Politics Done Right. Also going to send
Wonderful.
A big thank you
thank
out
you.
To Anonymous out in Katie, helping us out, really enjoys the show. We've got one more pledge wrapping up on the line. In these closing moments, we would love to hear from you.
So
thank you for that call.
Thank you so much
526-5738.
Okay, folks, I know two more calls can come in right now. 713-526-5738. I'm about to check
Thanks.
Out.
Because Anonymous out in Houston.
The news, Anonymous in Houston, thank you, love you all. Thank you for all those donations. Folks, listen to me. We are going to be checking out of here momentarily, but we can take yet another call. 713-526-5738. 713-526-5738. The news is coming up next. Politics Done Right. First of all, I want to thank my guest, my friend, David Cobb, I appreciate you for being here, my friend.
Thank you, Egberto. Thanks for what you do every week, week in, week out, providing a place for people to talk to each other.
Folks, The news is next. Stay tuned. Remember, support this station. Not only Politics Done Right, but every single program. That is what we're here for. We are this may sound, cliche. We are really here for you, and you are here for us. My name is Egberto Willis. I am out.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for listening to Politics Done Right. I am your host, Egberto Willis. You can personally reach me by sending an email to egberto@politicsdoneright.com. Remember, Egberto is spelled EGBERTO. Change starts with you. 90.1 KPFT gives you information not tainted by corporate interest. Please visit kpft.org and contribute. Let's ensure continued access to real information and news remain available to all. Again, thank you very much for listening to Politics Done Right.